can tell you all are very excited about him, but I find a certain irony here. Show of hands, those of you who kind of hope that Administrator Pruitt will just sort of make the EPA go away. How does it feel to be here today with pretty much everyone hoping that the very agency you are running is going to go away, literally?
Well, it's justified. I think as we look over the last several years, the agency that I'm tasked to lead at this point has been used by the previous administration to truly impact our country in ways that we never could have imagined 8 years ago. Jobs have been impacted. The authority that the Washington, D.C. has, the assumption of power and the accumulation of power, they've taken advantage of that. And so I think it's justified. I think people across this country look at the EPA much like they look at the IRS. And I hope to be able to change that.
Well, that's a big goddamn joke, huh? Laugh about, you know, completely incinerating your own department, this self-inflicted wound with happiness. You know, it's so predictable. You know, it's just not Pruitt. You know what I mean? It's just not Pruitt. It's the entire Republican Party. And it seems like they are no friend of the environment. They never really have been since Teddy Roosevelt. It seems like they're proud of the destruction. Okay, get rid of the regulations. Just put some more shit in the water, in the air. And it really hasn't ended. I'm going to go to this site here. In fact, I'm going to record on the screen so you'll be able to see this. I'm going to the League of Conservation Voters, and you can get a good look at the votes this past year, 2016. Votes by party, whether you're Democrat, Republican, or Independent. We don't have too many of those. We can go by Senate or by House. So let's take a quick look at the Republican Party here. So we're gonna select a party. And as you can see here, we start with Bradley Byrne from the great state of Alabama. 2016 score, 0%. Lifetime score, 0%. And then, you know, you have an entire list here of those who are probably below 5% or so. That's page one. Go to page two. What do we see? R straight through. Three. R's, four R's, five R's, and you can see the picture here. You know, it's just along down party lines. And, you know, I personally don't know every bill here, but it's kind of obvious when you shoot down every goddamn bill there is, there's a problem. If it's all from one party, that's a problem. So I guess the next thing to do is let's look at the bills. Yeah. So, for example here, this one bill is protecting farm workers from dangerous pesticides. There's a congressman from Arizona who wanted to offer an amendment, whereas the farm workers would be given the same protection as workers in other industries. I mean, they're working around pesticides. And so you would want to try to make it a little bit safe from the poisons. I mean, I remember when my Scottish Terrier, you know, died. He died from bladder cancer because Scottish Terriers, you know, have a weakness for pesticides. Their DNA just can't handle it. You know, and you would think that the health of farm workers would mean something. And when you look at the votes here, votes for 177, voting against 249. You have to really look at the party and then see how the vote is. And you see all of Alabama here, except for Terry Sewell, votes no. Okay, there must have been some Democratic district voted that way. But in general, you see, no, and mostly every frickin' no vote, you know, comes from the Republican Party. Not all of them, but most of them. Okay, I'm going to try to find my congressman. That would be Congressman Lobiondo, New Jersey. See how he voted. Pallone Smith. Okay. I wonder if he voted. Oh, here he is. No, he voted against it. You know, and there's a lot of farm workers in our area. So I guess the hell with them. You know, what's a little bit of pesticide going to do to you? So, yeah, it's very, very depressing here. You know, these votes, it's just, it's beyond belief how it's usually on party line. But, you know, you would think that some of these things would mean something to somebody. I mean, pesticides are nasty. But some people just don't seem to think protecting farm workers is the way to go. Even the Senate voted against it. It's a shame. The one thing that's really nice about this site is you can check out your individual congressperson. So as an example, as you can see on the screen here, I've got Frank Lobiondo. He scores 50% for 2016. Lifetime, a little bit better. And I have the list of things he voted for and against. So, for example, he voted for disaster funding for Flint, Michigan. And on the other hand, he went against the Clean Energy and Public Lands Amendment, California Water Resources, protecting the farm workers from dangerous toxins. That's the one I just spoke about. So, yeah, it's quite depressing because essentially, you know, you have one party voting one way. And, you know, I'm not here to tell you that every single, you know, vote here should go for this, for that. But, you know, we know which party is there to protect the environment, and it's not the Republican Party. You know, I'd go even further, to be honest with you, with what's going on here. But it's sad. It's really, really sad. And I think we're going to see a lot more of this crap.